John Boychu. Sudoku? Sudoku? The thing with the numbers. This
Hello.
Oh, you ready to go?
Oh, where are you going?
Hello.
This.
That's my daddy.
Hi. Hi. You have therapy now.
No, I don't.
You don't?
You gotta check it.
I will check it. Because they don't tell me everything.
The doctor come in. Because I was sick.
He said not right now?
And
okay.
She said you don't have to come in till tomorrow.
Okay. Sounds like a plan. Did you have boys?
Yep, that's my daddy.
Grandson. You're the grandson.
Yeah.
He's grandson too.
No,
right?
That's my dad.
He's a baby.
Oh, wow.
He,
he's just a
crowd. He's a good one. He's a
lot. That's your uncle? Is he bad?
Yeah.
Don't tell him.
Did he buy you a Christmas present?
Yeah, I did.
Yes, he did.
A little punk. I got you a Garfield in a music box.
See that?
Horrible.
Okay, guys.
Bye.
Let me, miss.
Yes, sweet.
Let me ask you a question.
If I can answer it, yes.
What time do I like to have that set up in the morning?
For you to go?
Yeah.
I have to look on the board and find out.
Okay. How many
and that's only if they don't change it.
How many times a day do you have to go?
Are you here for cardiac reasons?
Yeah. He has congestive heart failure.
Yeah, but
okay.
I don't know why they have
When you have cardiac, you go 1 hour occupational therapy, 1 hour physical therapy, and 1 hour like usually on those machines. Otherwise, it's like an hour and a half each one.
So 3 hours a day, Dad. Instead of sitting on your ass, you'll be working out. Yeah. 3 hours.
If they're going 3 hours a day, I need a beer.
Yeah, all right.
Got a good imagination?
Yeah, it does.
Okay.
All right, this tells you how to do it here. Now, you have your glasses, too. You know, your glasses should be in the drawer.
Come here, where's your finger? Let me see your finger.
Cheese.
What?
An empty box.
Cheese.
Of cheese?
Cheese.
Where do you get cheese?
And I planted flowers in there, and tomatoes come up.
From cheese?
No.
From the empty box.
Spontaneous tomatoation?
The school teacher used to go to different people's houses.
Uh-huh.
They didn't tell you when they were coming.
Really?
So she walked into my house.
Uh-huh.
I wasn't home because I was on Shirley Shoe. And when I got home, my mother said they left you a certificate. I said, for what? I said, for growing flowers and a cheese box.
Whew!
That's during the depression, though.
Was it sad?
Huh?
Was it a sad time back then, or was it good? The cheese flowers.
Yeah, we put them in with the salad.
No, he said, was it a sad time back then?
Real bad.
Tell me how it was.
I got up in the morning and went to school. I was always late for the school, and the teacher always hollered at me. You're always late for the school. Why are you late for the school? I live right next to the school.
What?
I used to jump over the fence. And then when I got out of school, I went home, changed my clothes, got my shiny box, and went shiny shoes until 11 o'clock at night.
Whew.
At 11 o'clock at night, I come home, I ate, did my homework, and went to bed. And the next day, the same thing.
Every day?
Every day.
Wow.
I used to maybe get $6 or $7.
A night?
Yeah.
Isn't that really good for back then?
Huh?
Isn't that really rich for back then?
No. I was shiny shoes, I don't remember it. And this Columbus Democratic Club. I was shining the guy's shoes, and he says to me, how would you like to make a couple of dollars?
Uh-huh.
Anthony?
Yes?
Hi, my name's Pinky. I'm from physical therapy.
It's another one.
Another
one?
What
are you, taking a shot?
Yeah, I heard you weren't feeling too well.
No, I told up all night.
All night?
They gave me stuff to calm me down.
Okay. Are you up for trying therapy at all?
Not today.
Not today? Still throwing up?
Doctor, the woman doctor come up and see.
Huh?
Yes.
You want the doctor to come and see you?
The woman doctor.
Dr.
Came
Fleming?
Up. Mm-hmm. Negro woman.
Yes, she's African American.
Yeah. Nothing.
She's African American. Continue.
All right, she came up and check me out and everything. She said, no, you can go tomorrow, not today.
Not today? Okay. All right, I want to check with you to see if you're up for it.
There was just another woman who was only here about 5-6 minutes.
She might have been somebody who's helping me. Her name is Jean. She's probably just checking on you. All right. Well, relax and hopefully you'll feel better tomorrow, okay?
What time do you have the first class?
Your first session is either 8:30 or 10. Let me check for you.
Interrupters, they're always there.
Okay, continue.
So anyway, the guy says to me, you want to make a couple of dollars?
Mm-hmm.
I said, is it legal? He says, oh, yeah. He says, I'm going to drop you. I'll pick you up tomorrow morning, and I'm going to take you by the high school.
Uh-huh.
Now, all you have to do is walk down alongside the fence all the way down until you find a small package.
Uh-huh.
And I walked down there and I found a package and I met him and he gave me $2.
Uh-huh.
So I found out afterwards he had horse bedding slips.
What was it for?
Did he say what was it for?
Uh-huh.
I just told you.
I mean...
Horse bedding slips.
The Democratic Republican Party?
No.
Did it?
It was a Democrat.
That was illegal back then.
Yeah.
Damn Democrats. That's so... You did that a lot?
Only a couple of times.
Was that the mob at all? Was that the mafia? Oh.
Probably.
Whoa. So what did you used to study in school?
Everything.
What was your favorite?
Manual training.
What?
Building things.
Oh.
Making birdhouses and stuff like that.
Uh-huh.
And one day I cut my whole thumbnail.
Off?
Right off.
Oh. I miss making birdhouses, Dad.
Somebody was talking to me and I'm using this call.
Anthony, you're at 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
10 o'clock?
Yeah, and then you're with me at 2:30. See you.
Spend the rest of the day with you.
Huh?
All right,
I'll see you
tomorrow, Anthony. Pimp. And well, we had to go to movies. We never asked our parents for any money.
No?
Like, go to movies, it costs you 10 cents.
That's pretty freaking cheap. I wish it was that cheap today.
Because they didn't have none, Michael.
They had Zorro.
Oh, he meant money.
You know, 3 or 4 days a week. You know, we had spaghetti and meatballs.
Oh, you're lucky. I love spaghetti and I love pasta.
Well, that was the cheapest thing you could buy that was...
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Half a pound of chopped meat.
Wow.
Which was the cheapest. Don't ask me what a steak looked like. I never seen one.
Wow. Wow.
And I remember one day there was this other Italian woman that lived on the floor but next door to us.
Uh-huh.
And she said, I want to cook up a chicken.
Mm-hmm.
She said, I need the chicken. I said, what are you going to do? She said, no, I want a live chicken. So we walked down to remember, Cupid Street, right on the corner. You walked in there, and the guy had all these chickens in a cage. You pick out the one you want. He took it out, grabbed it by the neck.
And killed it in front of you?
And then he cut off the rest, and they have a thing with it. They hang him up upside down, and all the blood goes out.
Oh.
And that was only about 25 cents.
For a chicken?
Yep.
That's pretty good. Did you ever kill any? Did you ever kill them?
No, I should be able to get them. Thank you, Jimmy. Thank you.
What was your favorite food when you were growing up?
Rice pudding.
Oh, you eat that a lot now.
Yeah, well, my mother used to make some rice pudding.
Can you tell me about your parents?
Huh?
Tell me about your mom. Oh, was she really nice? Was your mom really nice?
Yeah.
What was great about her?
She was my mother. My father came from Italy. My mother was born there. She was born here.
Ah, where was she born?
Newark.
Ah. How'd they meet?
I wasn't around to find out myself.
Yeah. What were their names?
My father's name was Louis.
Louis?
My mother's name was Madeline.
Madeline. Huh. And how many kids did they have?
Five.
Five?
Seven of us in a family.
Ah. Who else was there? You, Uncle Babe? Who else?
My sister and my twin brother and Tommy.
Who?
My oldest brother.
Who are all they?
What?
Who are all of them?
I just told you.
Oh boy.
Brothers and sisters.
You had a twin brother?
Yeah, I was a twin.
What's his name?
I don't know.
Huh?
Michael, he died when he was really small.
Oh, wow. Wow. And you had another brother named Tommy?
Yeah.
What happened to him?
You died GB.
Wow. And then you and Uncle Babe and Aunt, what's your name?
Tommy. And then there was Louie.
Louie? Oh, he's the one that lives in Jersey somewhere, right?
Who?
He lives in New Jersey, right?
He was up in Persephone.
Huh. And what was your sister's name?
Louise.
Louise. Huh. So it's you, Uncle Babe, and Louie left?
It's just really Uncle Babe and me.
Huh.
We have a problem with to run in over 30 years.
Wow. Wow. So what'd you like to do for fun when you were a kid?
Huh?
What'd you do for fun?
Went up to Olympic Park swimming.
Uh-huh.
You know that too?
Olympic Park, yeah. We used to go there.
Cool. Okay. And this...
We never belonged to any gangs.
That's good.
The whole neighborhood was all okay.
Yeah?
Then they say there's going to be a rumble tonight.
Uh-huh.
So what we did, we went down at 5 and 10. We bought a whole box of balloons. So we got them, we filled both of them up with water. And when the gang came around, we threw them off the roof.
Did they chase you?
I mean, nobody got hurt.
Wow.
They had a habit of the Italian people years ago.
Uh-huh.
Especially during the summer, when it was hot.
Uh-huh.
They used to get their chair and put their feet in the street.
Mm-hmm.
Where the water runs down. And we go up there, we got an old fish barrel.
Uh-huh.
Took both ends out, turned the water around, then put the fish barrel over it. And we had somebody standing on the corner every time he three blocks away with the police station.
Uh-huh.